Greetings from Nairobi, Kenya.
Hello, I'm good, thank you. For some reason, the internet connection doesn't work so well now, so I cannot hear you so well. I still try to get it better, but yeah, it's quite difficult.
Can you hear us?
Not so well.
Okay, we will try our best to speak to you. We will start right now, Kale. Thank you very much, first of all, for joining us. We're going to start in just a moment. My name is Sean, and next to me is Eddie. We are the moderators, thanks to Red Bull. And we will also see you during the safari because we are also the MCs for the event. We will be seeing you at the start, at the finish, and also during the event as well. So thank you very much for joining us.
No, thank you, and nice to meet you guys.
All right, we will start right now. When you're ready.
Yeah, I'm ready. I cannot see your picture, but I can hear you.
Oh, you can't see our picture. Just hold on. All right.
Yeah, it's frozen for me, but if I don't need to see it, it's fine.
All right, we will start. Hopefully, the picture will clear up as we go along, okay?
Yeah.
All right, we're starting in 3, 2, 1. So, welcome to the Red Bull Drivers Hangout with myself, Sean Carter-Villis, and Eddie Kimani. This has been such a special day. A little bit earlier, we spoke to Seb Ogier, the 7 times world champion. And of course, he's coming for the WRC Safari Rally in a couple of weeks' time. Now, I'm proud to have with us the 20-year-old driving sensation. He drives for Toyota Gazoo Racing, Kalle Rovanperä. Kalle, first of all, thank you very much for joining us. Where are you? You say you're at home. Are you back in Finland?
Yeah, thank you. I'm at home and I live in Estonia nowadays. So it's quite close to Finland, but yeah, I'm here.
All right. First of all, you had a very tough rally once again in Sardinia over the weekend. You've been having bad luck in the last couple of rallies. Just explain what went wrong for you in Sardinia.
Yeah, Sardinia was quite a tough rally for us. It started really well actually. Then on the stage four we had a mechanical issue with the car, and we were forced to retire for Friday, and then for the rest of the rally we just was focusing for the power stage mainly to try to get points from there. But yeah, that's rally sometimes. You also have mechanical issues sometimes, and sometimes you make the mistake, and there is many things what you can do, but yeah, we were quite unlucky last weekend.
All right, Kalle, thank you very much for joining us. It's a co-presenter here with Sean Carter-Villis. My name is Eddie, and it's really good that you've joined us here. I must tell you that there is great expectation in terms of the Kenyan fans here waiting for you. They've been following you through the last round, and indeed, you've proved a lot of people wrong from a very young age, coming from a rallying family, and I know to where you are right now. How big is it that you are coming to Safari Rally? You coming to Kenya where your dad last raced in 2002 and finished second in the WRC Safari Rally. How big is this? Has this already settled in your mind that you're coming for an adventure?
Yeah, for sure. I'm really looking forward for it. I have heard a lot of nice stories from my dad, from his trips, and so yeah, I'm really excited to come there.
Have you gotten a chance yet to just have some form of, for example, I know as a team you have preparations underway. I mean, considering just coming off a very tough and demanding Sardinia rally, have you started talking about Safari Rally yet, or are you just waiting to relax, recharge, and sort of just wait until in the course of the weekend start talking about Kenya?
Yeah, normally I also always have a small rest after the rally. After some time we start to prepare more for the next rallies. So for me also, I haven't been yet preparing for Kenya, but yeah, we have only this and next week time, so we have to prepare next week quite much for the rally.
Kalle, we saw videos of you testing with Toyota. We saw the terrain, which we must admit, the way the preparations looked, it looked quite similar to what we can expect during the Safari Rally, although, of course, the composition of the soil will be very different. There's a very soft volcanic soil in the Rift Valley here. How did that testing go for you? We saw that, I think it was early last week.
Yeah, the testing went quite well. I have to say that, of course, the conditions what we can have here is not completely same what we will see there. So yeah, for sure, that test before Sardinia was mainly also for Sardinia. So yeah, we have to see and try to be well prepared when we come there, but it's going to be tricky also.
The turnaround is very fast between the rallies. You know, you barely have time to rest, and then you're already thinking about the next rally. In terms of the Safari Rally, from a personal point of view, what are you expecting? What has your father told you? Of course, your father, Harry, had great success, particularly the 2002 rally where he finished second. What advice has he given you, bearing in mind that you've never rallied in Africa before?
I think he haven't given me so many advices yet. For sure, it's going to be difficult for him also. It has been a long time. All the cars and everything is different. I think also the rally is quite much more different than that time. But yeah, I think closer to the rally, he will give me some tips what he knows and remembers.
Fantastic. If you're watching us right now live on YouTube, on Facebook, you're watching a conversation between Kalle Rovanpera right here during the Red Bull Drivers Hangout. And this is a conversation we started off, of course, earlier on, speaking to the World Championship leader, that is Sebastien Ogier. And this time round, we are sitting with Kalle Rovanpera, one of the youngest, I should be the youngest in the WRC Championship, and is having a conversation with us as he prepares to get to the WRC Safari Rally later on in the month. Now, Kalle, of course, a lot of expectations from your teammates, and that's a question I really wanted to ask you today. Being one of the youngest, or the youngest rally driver, how much pressure do you have to deal with when you're working around very experienced drivers like the likes of Sodo and Sebastien Ogier? How is the camaraderie around in helping you work and put in results at this high level of rallying and where you are right now in your career?
Yeah, I think when I went to Toyota last year first time, it was nice to have Seb and Elfin as my teammates. For sure, they have so much more experience that it's nice to see during the rallies and follow what they do and what kind of things they make. So I can learn quite much from them. And also, for me, it's always easier to see from data and stuff what they do during the rally. So yeah, it helps.
Kalle, just looking at your career, first of all, you've got a very close association with Estonia. We see you at your house in Estonia. If you can tell us why Estonia, we can see that your first rally, you took part in Estonia at just 10 years old, competing in Latvia, nearby Latvia, at 13 years old. Why Eastern Europe? Just tell us that connection.
Yeah, I started my career in Baltics, Estonia and Latvia. And that time it was the reason why I did it, because I couldn't drive in Finland. The regulations were different in Estonia and Latvia. So it was possible for me to start driving there. That is the reason.
All right.
Because I was so young.
Yes, of course. We can see that. Amazing. You'd literally, I think from the age of three, you had already started driving. I can see that you drove an ATV. That's, of course, a quad bike or a three-wheeler at only 3 years old. At 5 years old, you helped your dad, I can see, with the construction. You're already driving. So coming from a motorsports family with your father being a rally driver, you got exposure at a very young age. It looks like you were destined for success.
Yeah, it was really nice to start to drive when I was so young with ATVs and bikes and cars and everything. So for me, it was always quite easy to drive everything because I was learning them when I was so young. And yeah, that is also one of the reasons why I'm now driving rally, because
yeah, we can see you had a lot of success. 2015, we can see you went up to another level as well.
Quite young and always been enjoying it.
Our apologies, we're having a little bit of an issue with the audio. If you can still hear us, you did step up to another level 2015. Just tell us from 2015 onwards in terms of your success until you joined the WRC.
Yeah, 2015 we started to drive a bit more, how can I say it, professionally. We tried to do everything in a bit better way and started to prepare for the career more. And then, 2015 onward, we started to do full championships in Baltics. And then 2018 we went to World Rally Championship with the official team Skoda. And then 2020, I joined Toyota for WRC team. So, yeah, it was quite quick few years moving on all the time.
Right, fantastic. Kalle, of course, I could be wrong, but you can correct me. You might be the only current WRC driver who has the closest connection with the Safari Rally, with your dad having taken part in the WRC Safari Rally. Of course, his last one being in 2002. How much have you personally looked at trying to research a little bit more about the Safari Rally? Are you planning to sit down with your dad just to take us through a journey of how you're planning to approach this big, big, humongous challenge that is ahead of you, which I know all of us know that you're up to?
Yeah, I think for me it's quite nice to have this experience from dad, and I think I have always watched the old videos from all the rallies, and I have been also watching all the videos and clips from Safari Rally. So it has been nice to see and experience these things and hear all the stories from dad. So I think before the race, we will talk with him and see if he has still some ideas for me.
All right, let's just talk a little bit about the car dynamics in relation to the upcoming Safari Rally. I mean, cars right now have developed so much compared to the days your dad was in the WRC Safari Rally. The dynamics that are presented to us right now is really advanced. And maybe is it a conversation that you're already having with the rest of the team in terms of how Safari Rally now comes to play with how the other five rounds of this year's season has gone so far?
Yeah, I think with the cars nowadays, they are so much different. And to be honest, it's quite tricky for us to really know what's coming in the Safari before we go there. So, yeah, I think all the setups and dynamics of the cars is going to be quite different in Safari, maybe. And then for the first half of the season, we didn't
All right, we're having one or two issues with the audio. Kalle, can you hear us?
Yeah.
All right, okay. If you can hear us, you're talking about the setup of the cars. We know it's not like before, where in the days of your dad, they used to have almost a separate car for the Safari Rally. In terms of what you've heard and the team has heard, we know that there's some very big rocks that can appear. I know you've rallied in the likes of Turkey. before where you've seen big rocks. It's volcanic soil as well, very soft. The rocks can dislodge. Anything you're thinking of in terms of the setup, or do you wait until you come here and you go into the recce and then you decide from there?
I think we for sure we need to prepare, and we try to prepare soon as we can already before we come there. But yeah, I think after the recce we will know what we really need from the car and what we can do. But yeah, I think Rally Turkey has been now these last few years the roughest rally of the season. So I think we have to try to take some ideas from Rally Turkey also, and try to prepare the car a bit in the same way when we come to Safari.
We've got a lot of young drivers who are competing in this rally. We've got a young drivers program. There are three drivers who have been given the Ford R3 cars to compete in the Safari Rally. This is courtesy of our government, the Kenya government, and the FIA. We've also got a young ladies team, possibly the youngest crew, to be taking part in the Safari Rally. What advice, with you coming through the system, our system, of course, is not as developed as yours, particularly, of course, Finland churning out champions, you know, every generation. What advice would you give to our young drivers, a lot of them who are taking part in the Safari for the first time?
Yeah, I think the best advice what I really can give is that always you need to try to be the best as you can, and learn from the mistakes and stuff that you're having. If you have some ideas or things that are not maybe same than others, you need to be brave to test them and try to have your own style and everything. So I think that is the most important thing, just to follow your own feeling and always try to be better than last time.
Kyle, of course, you've got an amazing story, driving from the time you are 6 years old. So definitely that means you had already sat in a car and settled in very well at an early age. Now, as Sean mentioned here, we have a program that is supporting the young rally drivers, and I'm sure they're looking forward to have this conversation with you. Of course, this will be a recorded version, but we will be able to just hear more from you as they chart out their journey. And anything you think that would stand in the way for a local African young driver to progress on, to even pursue an opportunity? I mean, dreams are valid, to get up to the WRC. Just an insight to how much and what it takes to get to where you are.
It takes a lot. I think, like in motorsport, it's really difficult always to be in the right place at the right time. You can have really good results and everything, but if there is just no really good place for you at that time or something like this, it doesn't help. So I think you always need a bit of luck in motorsport also. And I think you need to have really good support for your program. You need to drive a lot, and motorsport can be really expensive, so it's important to have a good support and a lot of kilometers in the racing cars. I think those are the most important things. Try to have the program where you have a lot of races and good races for you to show your speed and experience.
Definitely amazing advice, which I think should be taken in with every importance that you've shared with. What's your biggest motivation factor to always get into that car and push for good results? You're young, you're energetic, you've got an amazing team around you, you've got a legendary father, and some of us on this other end, the young ones, some of them don't have that, but they might like what you do to be able to motivate yourself every round to get into that car and push and get results, and also to learn that sometimes you don't get to win or you don't get to the podium. But what keeps you moving forward?
For me personally, it's the feeling of winning and the feeling of trying to win. That is the motivation for me. I always want to be the best or try to be the best. It's really important for me to always try to improve and try to be better than others. I think that is motivating me a lot, and I think that is the motivation what you really need if you want to be one of the best some days. You need to have this feeling and this feeling to fight for the wins.
Kalle, just tell us a bit about yourself in terms, I know you're 20 years old, do you have time for any hobbies, or what do you do outside of rallying, and also family life? You live in Estonia, we can see, well away from Finland and your family. Married, what do you do in terms of your personal life away from the WRC and away from rallying?
I think my hobbies are quite much based on motorsport. I have always been liking all the motorsport stuff, driving different kind of race cars. I do quite much drifting in my spare time. Those are my main hobbies. I also drive sometimes simulators, racing simulators. And then when I'm home or visiting Finland, sometimes I just want to see my family and friends. That's quite important for me also, because I'm traveling a lot. It takes a lot of time, so I think those are the quite main things what I do besides rallying.
How much pressure do you feel as a Finnish driver? Finland, of course, with a long and proud history in motorsports, particularly rallying. How much pressure do you feel as a youngster with you now, of course, in one of the top teams in the world? You've got great mentors in Sebastian Ogier. You've also got Elfyn Evans there as well. How much pressure do you feel, especially as a Finn, and rallying?
Yeah, I can really see that there is a lot of expectations for me. People are from Finland are waiting a lot for good results always, and things like this. So I think there is for sure some pressure on me always, but I think there has always been a bit, and I'm also making quite much pressure for myself. I'm always pushing myself a lot. So I think the biggest pressure always comes from myself. I want to push myself a lot. So yeah, there is pressure from my side also.
All right, Kalle, we are just winding up the conversation, but as I've heard from across the various channels, as the build-up towards the WRC Safari Rally is happening, we understand a couple of drivers already taking some few Swahili lessons. So we'd like to, hopefully, me and Sean here, teach you one or two words in Swahili. So by the time you land at the airport, you already tell the guys there we are here to do some serious business. So are you ready?
Yeah.
Or I think the most simple word that maybe just to start you off would be a greeting.
Yes,
and so which one do we start with?
Hello in Swahili is jambo.
Jambo?
Ah, yes.
Yeah, J-A-M-B-O, jambo.
Okay, jambo.
And for more? You to respond, of course, if somebody says jambo to you, to be, which word would we use? Jambo. You could say back jambo. How are you? Which one do you use? Niaje. Niaje. Yeah, so we've got a sort of like slang also here, and Swahili is mixed up, but jambo would open up any door for you anytime when you're here, when you land in Kenya. So definitely looking forward to that, because we are really proud of the fact that you are coming to continue the legacy of the Rovan Pera family, and we are really grateful that the Rovan Pera family is associated with Kenya. So we're really proud of you, and we are really happy with the results you're putting through. It's a lot of work, but we're looking forward to see how the battle is going to be. And our boys will not be any pushover. I can give you a heads up on that. But remember to use the word jambo.
Okay, I will. Thank you.
Not, only that, Kalle, we're so proud that we've got a Finnish driver coming for the rally, because Finland, with a long and proud history, you know, with the Safari Rally, we're really proud. I've just got one more question for you. We see in motorsports that there's so many young drivers coming through the system. In Formula One, as you well know, a lot of young drivers from Carlos Sainz Jr. We see young drivers, Max Verstappen himself is not that old himself. Also in rallying as well, a lot of young drivers coming through. You must be quite excited at the prospect that there's so much talent, young talent in motorsports at the moment.
Yeah, I've always been really excited to be one of the young talents myself also, and I think it's really good for the sport to have a lot of young people coming for the seats and coming for the professional level. It always makes the sport more interesting when there is new young people coming. So it's really nice to be part of that by myself and to see also a lot of other young people coming to the motorsports.
I mean, it's always a guarantee to have a new breed coming in, every generation bringing in new names. It's an amazing question because when the seniors, when, for example, Sebastian Loeb retired, we've got Sebastian Ogier who's talking about retiring. It's not really confirmed about it. We're always asking the question, who's next? But right now, we already have an answer in front of us. So very quickly, Kalle, just before we wrap up, we've been asking the questions. We'd like to find out if you have a question or questions for us.
Is there something special what I should do there when I have a few days free time? Is there something what I should see or do?
Yeah, sure. You've got the national parks. You've got the national parks to visit. We've also got beautiful beaches should you have time. But we would highly recommend the national parks. And also, since you're 20 years old, I'm sure there's one or two nightclubs that we can take to you, COVID protocols, of course, in place.
Definitely. We are proud about our country, and we've got a national park in the middle of the city. So that is one of the amazing pillars of what makes Nairobi and Kenya what it is. So that would be one of the ideal, considering also the time available for you to move. But you'll be Naivasha. Naivasha is also a hub. Yeah, they've got conservancies there. We've got a couple of lakes in the county there that you can visit in the national parks around there. So there's quite a lot for you to do when you get a window or two.
And not only that, Kalle, you will be seeing quite a few animals, wildlife, while you're rallying, because the route, there's a lot of zebras, giraffes. You will see that. Even during your recce, you'll be stunned by the scenery. It is absolutely beautiful, and it's right in the middle of our conservancies where the wildlife is as well. Anything else you would like to know about Kenya itself?
Yeah, not really yet. I think that's already good advice what I should do. I'm personally looking really forward to see all the wildlife and animals. I think it's really cool to see them. So yeah, I think I'm really looking forward for it. And maybe I will have some new questions when I'm there and I see the country more.
All right. Thanks very much. Kalle Rovanperä, the 20-year-old Finnish sensation driving for Toyota Gazoo Racing. We know you've had a small run of bad luck, but I'm sure that's going to change during the Safari Rally. Of course, as we've mentioned several times, that really, it's a fresh start for everyone because of all the rally drivers in the WRC, none of them have rallied in Africa. So, Kalle, once again, thank you so much for sparing time from Estonia. I know you're having a well-earned rest, but we really appreciate you speaking to us here at the Red Bull Drivers Briefing. Thank you so much for speaking to us.
Thank you. It was nice to be here. Thank you.